to the people, we never go to Africa or South America, so that's what we try to do.
Right, well, let's meet the first animal that you have. This is a bush baby?
It's a bush baby.
All right.
And what you're seeing here...
She's coming towards me. Am I holding the baby first?
Yes, you are.
Okay, hold it there. Okay, and you can give them a grape or a cookie or...
Okay.
Would you like a grape or a cookie or a...
Yeah.
Let's see if that's where?
Anywhere.
Anywhere?
But this is a bush baby, everyone. And a bush baby, everybody, is a prosimian. Prosimian, which means pre-monkey and pre-ape. On the planet before the monkeys mate. Can you imagine that? That's how old
they are. Before the monkeys and apes.
Well, you know, this one's been here that long.
No, that would be an old.
Yeah, that would be an old. But look at the hands. I think you see it on TV. Look at the hands. Just like your hands. Isn't that amazing?
Yes.
Little hands like yours.
And what is this related to?
This is in the primate family, obviously.
Uh-huh.
And this animal, by the way, it's amazing. When I go to Africa and film these at nighttime, everyone, you go out there with your cameras, infrared cameras, red eyeballs everywhere out there. They separate nighttime, and that's when they eat the little insects, like little worms, things like that, and fruit, and that type of thing.
And this was rescued from somewhere, right?
That's a rescued animal. Someone had that as a pet. And that's what you cannot do, everyone. Primates carry diseases. They bite.
Why am I holding it?
That's what I asked.
Yeah.
But this has been raised in the logic part.
They're very soft. Very, very soft.
They change very little in the tens of thousands of years.
Oh, God. Amazing. All right.
So much.
What's your name?
Mel.
Thank you, Melanie. Okay. Here's your mommy. Doesn't really care to be.
But they're a neat creature to fill in nighttime and Africa. You don't like safaris.
God, that's amazing. That's just beautiful.
You got to ask me sometimes.
I know. I want to go. I keep saying I want to go. Now we have a large bird. All right.
Now this bird, this everybody, this is great. I've never had one of these on TV ever.
Okay.
This is a screamer. No.
Let's give it some things.
Don't hurt it.
Here.
Oh.
Let me ask you. Do you want some corn or something?
This is a screamer, Ellen.
Uh-huh. That's what it's called, a screamer?
Yeah. It dates back to the dinosaur. It's got a big bone in its chest like a dinosaur.
Uh-huh.
And this animal also
screams.
This is a male screamer.
It also looks like it could be a turkey.
It looks kind of screwed up, doesn't it?
Uh-huh.
Everybody listen. This animal here screams, and all the females come to him, right? And then he obviously looks at his females.
Uh-huh.
And then that way, if another male comes around, he takes his wings like that, and there's a spur. I need Alvin to show the TV to people at home. This is dates back to the dinosaur. There's a spur on the end of his wing. I need to show this to the camera. It's amazing. And this spur, look at this. See right there on the end of that wing? Looks
uh-huh.
like a dart.
Uh-huh.
Isn't that amazing?
Wow.
And that's how he tears apart the other bird, another male, to try to come and get his females.
That's not nice.
Oh, yeah. He likes lettuce.
Lettuce? You want some lettuce?
They live in water, not up to over there. They're like big turkeys, but
you want this?
They live in water, and the animals eat lettuce like this. They also have a horny tongue. That's because the tongue, it's got like, that wasn't my word. My information said that. They have a tongue with like spurs on it, but that's what it said. And that's where you can tear the lettuce.
So we want to take this away now because we have the next album. We don't want this one near the next album. Okay,
no,
we
sure don't,
no.
This next album won't eat lettuce. It'll eat you.
Yes, that's what I know. So are we going to feed the next album?
Oh, yeah. We'll go over here, though.
Okay. Make sure we get that one far away.
This is an alligator.
Alligator. And the difference between alligator and crocodile?
Well, the crocodile has much ridges on top. Are much longer, its nose is more pointed, and the teeth are different. But they can outrun any human being in the first 20 yards.
Yeah, that's why I'm kind of nervous. This is also a rescue. This was someone at a crack house. Is that where you got this?
Right. That's where
a crack house.
Someone has, people tend to still bring gators back from Florida, the little ones, right? That's fine. People think they can do that. Don't do that because what happened is it grows into a big gator, then of course you can get eaten, and that's not
well,
good.
Let me ask why this is okay, or is it that we're standing here? Why is it?
Well, come here, David. David raises this alligator for a young shirt. We teach us to teach folks about the alligator. And what I want to show you, the camera can show you this. Let me show you the diagram. They have two eyelids on the camera. You can see this eye right here. If you can see underwater, the animal has two eyelids. He'll open his eye here in just a second. He'll open his eye in just a second. And you'll see another eyelid pop over there. There we go.
Wow. So that it can see underwater. It has little goggles.
Right. They have sensors down right here. They have sensors here. A gator hunts vibrations. People don't realize that. You can be swimming and something about 2 miles away. They feel the vibration in the water like sonar. He comes up and grabs his prey, whatever it might be, and he pulls it down like that. You just don't get around a gator. There's so many of them in Florida now.
No.
They always show you that. If we can show you down this
real
valley
quick,
here.
Before we go to break, tell me what?
and grabbed his